Good morning, USA. I got a feeling that it's gonna be a wonderful day. The sun in the sky has a smile on his face, and he's shining a salute to the American race. Oh boy, it's swell to say,
good morning, USA.
Good morning, North. I'm Maddie.
And I'm Abigail.
And today is Wednesday, September 21st. Go to all of your odd classes today.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Here are today's birthdays.
It's your birthday. It's your birthday.
Hispanic Heritage Month fact for today is Cinco de Mayo is a holiday some people celebrate in Mexico, but it is not the Independence Day. It commemorates a battle in the city of Puebla, Mexico in 1862.
Hi, North. Mrs. Fink here with What You're Reading Wednesday, and in honor of Hispanic Heritage Month, which started last week, I would like to talk to you about this awesome book, Marcus Vega Doesn't Speak Spanish. And let me tell you, just from the first page, what Marcus has to say about himself. Most kids clear out of the way when I walk down the hall. They're like campers in a forest who spot a grizzly and scramble up a tree to hide, or in this case, climb into a locker. I've been called the Mastodon of Montgomery Middle, the Springfield Skyscraper, the Moving Mountain, the Terrible Tower, the... You get the idea. Okay, Marcus is tall. He's like 6 feet, 180 pounds, eighth grade. And unfortunately, people look at him as a threat because of his size. When really, he is a really awesome kid, very kind, cares a lot about his family. He lives with his mom and his younger brother. And one day at school, somebody says something about Marcus's younger brother that's really cruel, and Marcus can't take it, and he punches the kid, gets in a fight, and he's facing suspension now at school. So Marcus's mom decides they kind of need a reset, they need a break, so they're going to go to Puerto Rico and spend some time away and meet some relatives that Marcus has never met. And Marcus is having a hard time focusing while he's there because all he can think about is his father is also somewhere on the island, his father who walked out about 10 years ago. So through a series of misadventures and some funny times too, Marcus is searching for his father and meeting some new people along the way. So if you want to know the answers to, did he find his father? Did he get suspended from school? Did he learn a little Spanish? I don't know. You should come read the book and find out.
Here are the after-school activities. Fill out a green pass and get it signed by a team teacher and meet in the cafeteria by 3:05.
Hi everyone, it's Mrs. Owens here. Happy Wednesday. Wanted to tell you about a new club starting soon. It's the Minecraft for Education Club. If you're interested, on Thursday this week, Thursday morning, you will see around school QR codes for you to sign up. This club is limited to the first 20 folks that sign up on this QR code. So Thursday morning, look around the school. There will be a QR code right outside the counseling center. So first thing Thursday morning, if you're interested, sign that QR code and get signed up. Our very own Mr. Bosque has volunteered to host this Minecraft club. Awesome. Thank you so much, Mr. Bosque. But we're excited to offer that again this year. So again, this Thursday morning, if you're interested in the Minecraft for Education Club, scan that QR code and sign up. I will email the first 20 folks to sign up. I will email you and let you know if you are in. It will get started probably in a couple weeks. It takes a couple weeks for Mr. Borgman to get those loaded onto our iPad. So I will email you and listen to announcements to find out when that first date will be. But again, Thursday morning will be when we see that first QR code for Minecraft for Education Club. Have a great day, guys.
Hey, y'all. Are you in or do you support the LGBTQIA plus community? Well, if so, you should join the Pride Club. It's on Thursdays at room 36. We are a safe space and we accept all genders, sexualities, races, and hair colors. We bring snacks, so you should definitely join.
We got a lot of hair color.
Yeah!
Come to Pride Club.
Playful.
Join the chaos.
My God.
Okay, we include all hair colors.
It started with a whisper, and that was when I kissed her, and then she made my lips.
And now we're going to continue our interviews from yesterday about the upcoming play.
Hi, my name is Abigail, and I'm here with Mallory. Have you ever been in a play before?
I was in High School Musical last year, but I wasn't like a leading role or anything.
What character are you playing in Narnia?
I'm Aslan the lion.
Awesome. What do you think of, what's your favorite thing about the play?
I love the people in it and I love the outcome of like the feeling of like it being over and stuff.
And is there anything you'd like to add?
Come see it. We need people to come and watch. So.
Great, thanks.
Hi, my name is Kate and I'm here with Jake. Is there anything you're excited for the upcoming play?
I'm excited to do the play and be on stage and have people watch the play.
Nice. What part are you playing?
I'm playing Edmund!
Awesome. Are you planning on trying out for the musical?
I don't know yet, but maybe, yeah.
Okay. What can we look forward to?
The best play ever.
Nice. Thank you.
I'm Maddie, and I'm here with Carolyn. Have you ever been in a play before?
Yes, I actually have. I was in Willy Wonka in first grade.
Awesome! What character are you playing in Narnia?
I'm actually not a character. I am an assistant director.
Cool! What's your favorite thing about doing the play?
All the people. It's really fun having a big cast, too. It's a really big cast, so it's a lot of fun to jig around.
Yeah, I can see that. Is there anything else you'd like to add?
You should come see the play. It's supposed to be fun, I think.
Thank you.
With Lilia, and we're going to be discussing the play. Is there anything you're excited for?
I'm excited just being in the play because I've been in a few, but not in, like, really school, so it's exciting just being in it.
Yeah, and what part are you playing?
I'm a wood nymph, so like a forest creature.
That's great. And are you planning on trying out for the musical?
I am planning on trying out for the musical. It was, just sounds fun, so yeah.
And what can we look forward to?
Well, it's gonna be very different than, like, War of the Worlds. There's, like, different, like, characters, of course, and like parts and things like that.
Yeah, that's awesome. Anything else you'd like to add?
No.
All right, thank you.
Welcome to our new news segment called Fantasy Football Tips by me, Will, and Charlie.
Fantasy Football Tips is where we inform you on who to sit, who to start, and who to pick up on the waivers every single week.
Our must-start QB for this week is Joe Burrow.
He's bound to have a great game after his poor play in these past 2 weeks. He also plays against a trash defense from the New York Jets. Our must-sit QB for this week is Tua.
Tua's coming off an amazing week with 6 touchdowns and nearly 40 fantasy points. However, he will definitely not do that again, and people are getting their hopes up way too high for Tua. He's also playing the best defense in the league in the Buffalo Bills.
Our must-start running back for this week is Cordell Patterson.
Cordell Patterson has been on a roll in his first 2 weeks, getting 25 points his first week as well. He is the only offensive weapon for Marcus Mariota this week, going up against the terrible Seattle Seahawks defense with a now injured Jamal Adams. Start Cordell Patterson.
Our must-sit running back for this week is Najee Harris.
Najee Harris is still a little bit banged up from his training camp injury on his foot. To add on to that, the Steelers cannot get their offense rolling. They're also playing the great defense from the Browns with the lead of Myles Garrett on the line. Our must-start wide receiver is A.J. Brown.
A.J. Brown is coming off an average week, putting up about 11 points. But week one, he put up 25-plus points. He's also playing a terrible Commanders defense, and people are forgetting how good he can be. Start A.J. Brown this week. Our must-sit wide receiver for this week is Jaylen Waddle.
Jaylen Waddle did have a great week this past week, all the people are hyping up way too much, and they are forgetting that he plays the number one defense in the league, the Buffalo Bills.
Our must-start tight end for this week is Tyler Higbee.
Tyler Higbee gets more targets than expected when you play alongside Cooper Kupp and Allen Robinson. He's also playing the Arizona Cardinals, who have Budda Baker, but he will be focused on Cooper Kupp. Our must-sit tight end for this week is Dalton Schultz.
Dalton Schultz is playing a pretty average Giants defense, but he's sharing targets with CeeDee Lamb, who we are sure will be back this week, and he also has Cooper Rush throwing him the ball. Don't start Dalton Schultz. He hasn't been good all year.
Thanks. Our number one waiver wire pickup for this week is Garrett Wilson on the New York Jets as the wide receiver one.
This rookie is coming off a 20-plus point week from last week and is bound to have a great weeks coming up. Pick up Garrett Wilson on the waiver wires. He's going to go off, and he's pretty clear-cut Jets wide receiver one.
No cap.
Your lunch options for today are pizza, nachos, cheeseburgers, and strawberry parfait.
Have a great day, and remember,
Buzz before us!